anybody that knows me knows that I love projection and I love films, and that has been my passion my entire life. My only experience so far has been with 35 millimeter film, so I decided to make my job and my craft also a hobby. So I got a Bell Howell 8mm home projector here from the 50s, I believe. I've got the take-up reel here with the electrical outlet still wrapped around. Here's the lamp house where you put the reels on. Got the lens, the bulbs in here already, the manual rollers. And this is the pedestal where you can prop the projector up to get it at a higher shot. You can speed up the film depending on the frame rates it was shot in. Or, I'm sorry, the frames per second it was shot in. The motor lamp, blah, blah, blah. Everything else is self-explanatory. You can go forward to play the film, reverse to rewind the film, keep it still. All right, I'm going to throw on a couple films I have. I've got Son of Frankenstein here, and I've got Rodan the Flying Monster. So I'm going to thread these up and play them through. It being a digital age and digital projection having taken over the industry, you don't get to do stuff like this or see stuff like this very often these days, and it's pretty cool. Although, I will say, I do think that digital projection provides a really beautiful image. There is a certain quality to film projection that is unique and exciting every time you see it, especially nowadays with it being so rare. Of Frankenstein is up first. I'm going to go ahead and position it up on the pedestal there, and I'm going to run and thread the film. So this is all leader film, and 35 millimeter, you always have to splice the leader film onto the main film itself. So when I bought this and I bought some films, I went ahead and bought a bunch of rolls of leader in 8mm. And turns out most films you buy come with leader already attached. So that's pretty nice. But I will say my first film I got, which was a 7-minute Disney film about cats. I snapped the leader film when I was trying to figure out how to thread it. So run the film for a second. Okay. I snapped the film, so it was pretty much, I had a problem. So I don't recommend not having spare leader film. Because now I've had to order a splicing kit, the leader I ordered ended up being useful, but I had to order a splicing kit, which I actually still haven't received. So that film is just kind of not gonna be played until I can repair the front leader. So pretty much, I gotta hope these leaders don't break before my splicing kit comes in. So once I get the film in there, I'm gonna close the lens on it, give it a little more slack. And 35, you have top and bottom loops. Not quite the same with 8mm, but in a sense, it's similar. You wanna create a little tension, or a little slack. So it's not super tight as it's running through. I actually couldn't find any videos or instructions on how to thread this specific 8mm projector. So I just kind of played with it, and it took me about 30 to 45 minutes, and I just kind of figured it out. And I feel like I've gotten better. This will be the 5th movie that I'm playing. There you go. So the leader is right here. You can see it. It's coming through. I'm still on the leader. The movie is about to play, so I'm going to go ahead and play the movie.
We're going to run it through. I'm going to switch on the lamp.
this is a print from the 30s. And while you can see plenty of dirt on the film, there's not a terribly large amount of scratches. It's just dirty. And I'm actually going to look into how to clean 8mm film, and I'm going to try to clean some of these. But this print is from the 30s, so it's give or take almost 90 years old, and it still looks good, and it's still a really cool way for me to see this film that has been on my list. Like, Son of Frankenstein has been on my list for a long time. I love the Universal Hammer horror films, and for the first time I see it, I get to see it on 8mm film. So it's very cool.
All right. So as the film finishes up, you'll see it run through here and then take up. So you're gonna wanna kill the lamp. You're gonna wanna kill the lamp and then kill the motor. Now this is magma hot. One more fun thing, I have, but have not played yet, a feature print of Buster Keaton's The General. I'm really excited. Buster Keaton is one of my favorite filmmakers, and this is my favorite feature film that he did. So I'm excited. I need certain equipment. I need Extend A Reel equipment to play because it's such a big reel. I've got Extend A Reels here that I got on B&H, and here's my two rolls of leader film I got. Clear and red. But yeah, I need some more equipment before I can play this, but I just thought it was cool and I thought I would share.